Eichmann and Himmler are turning the screws. The Führer, they say, grows impatient. How can it be Denmark's Jews still walk free after 3 years of kind occupation? We will take them like sheep in their beds as they sleep on the second night of their new year. Devoutly at home, they'll be helpless alone. When they cry out, no one will hear. But Duke Fitz, the German, tells head off the Dane, "My friend, I have dangerous news. In 3 hours, the transport ships will set at anchor. You must warn them, warn all the Jews. Soon good Rabbi Melchior stands in the synagogue. There'll be no service today. The raids come tomorrow, dwell not on your sorrow. By nightfall we must be away. And it's fire up the diesel and look out for swells. We're leaving Espagueta behind us. Who strike at our friends, strike us as well. We'll pray the patrol boats don't find us. When the sirens are wailing and shouts fill the night, never will you stand alone. So it's over the years till the day we can welcome you home." Sapolinsky, the tailor, on the eve of Rosh Hashanah, gathers his family near. "The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom on this earth shall I fear?" When a young Danish Gentile steps into the glow of the candle with tears flowing down, good neighbors flee. I pray you believe me. And as quickly the young man is gone. Christian policemen, shopkeepers, and teachers tell their friends of the quickening storm. While students on bicycles race through the streets, searching for Jews to be warned. And Katlov, the foreman, blurts out to the trainman, "My family has no place to hide." "Well, bring them to my house," the stranger replies, "and we'll spit in the damn Nazi's eyes." It's fire up the diesel and look out for swells. We're leaving Espagueta behind us. Who strike at our friends, strike us as well. We'll pray the patrol boats don't find us. When the sirens are wailing and shouts fill the night, never will you stand alone. So it's over the years until the day we can welcome you. Nielsen, the fishwife in the port of Dragur, has no use for political views. She'll call out the catch, fresh salmon, fresh cod. Comes a whisper, "Please help, we are Jews." But if you are Jews, you're not safe on the street. I know a man with a sail. Till moonrise they sleep in the shade of her eaves and escape on the fisherman's keel. Rabbi Melchior hires a young trawler man to ferry his family across. After 12 hours afloat in a scurfy old boat, morning light shows the same Danish coast. Says the skipper, "I'm afraid of the German blockade, so we've motored in circles around." The rabbi gives a shout, with one blow knocks him out, and steers a straight line across the Sound. Frozen with fright in the October night, families huddle in basements and barns, mistaking each breath for the angel of death, the Gestapo, the shot, the alarm. Then down into the hold, with the stench and the cold, and drug all the babies with schnapps. Someone shouts, "Willkommen till Sverige. You are in Swedish waters at last." 7,000s of Jews smuggled over to Sweden by fishermen, nurses, and priests. Hitler sends Eichmann to hunt them down, but his quarry have vanished like mist. When the war's over, the Jews return, tears and flowers adorn their way home. We're not heroes or martyrs, so say the Danes, we were just looking after our own. And it's fire up the diesel and look out for swells, we're leaving Espagueda behind us. Who strike at our friends, strike us as well. We'll pray the patrol boats won't find us. When the sirens are wailing and shouts fill the night, never will you stand alone.